Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel and lovely greetings from the Deutsches Museum here in Munich, Germany. Today's video, I'll be talking about one of the most classic passenger questions: what happens if an airplane gets hit by lightning? So let's get started.
1383, runway 27, clear takeoff. United 1537.
Today's video is brought to you by Away Suitcases. All Away carry-on suitcases come with an integrated power bank, so you can fully charge your mobile phone up to 5 times. Plus, all their products come with a lifetime warranty. Visit awaytravel.com/joe to get a $20 discount on any suitcase and use promo code Joe during checkout. I've heard many weird rumors about this topic, like the airplane experiences a total system loss or the pilots get blinded by the light so they won't be able to continue the flight any further. That's odd because I've personally encountered numerous lightning strikes and none of these rumors matches my experiences. And trust me, planes get hit by lightning a lot. I would say every pilot experiences 2 to 3 lightning strikes each year. But how can planes continue flying through the sky after being hit by lightning? Now, the best way of showing what really happens is by doing an experiment here at the Deutsches Museum. Now, behind me, you can see this little steel cage, which will be our plane for today. If you squint your eyes a little bit, it more or less looks like a Boeing. So what we'll do is I'll climb into the cage and get lifted up into the air, and John, who's leading the experiment, will start the generators to generate the necessary power and voltage for the lightning. And to actually show the lightning hitting the steel chamber, they've installed these 2 arms with brass endings where the lightning will be visible. Then the cage will be submitted to 220,000 volts, so not the average output from your living room socket. And because I believe in English physicists and German engineering, I'll touch the inner skin of the cage as it gets hit by lightning. So let's get airborne. As we approach in a thunderstorm area, the first thing to do is to request an avoidance heading via ATC and simultaneously reduce the airplane's speed to a safe turbulence speed. If there's no way out and you have to cross through a yellow or even a red marked area presented on your weather radar screen, you're most likely going to encounter a lightning strike. And then this happens. That was pretty loud. So, as you saw in the video, I was able to touch the inner skin of the steel cage. But how can that be if there were 220,000 volts rushing through that cage? Now, most airplanes are built out of metal, primarily alloy. And as we look at the airplane from this perspective, the lightning strike hits the metal surface, the electrons of the lightning strike flow onto the metal surface, but electrons have the characteristics to push themselves away from each other as they have the same negative charge. So where would you think will the electrons flow along the metal? On the inner or the outer part of the airframe structure? Obviously on the outer part, otherwise this would have been the last video on my channel. The outer skin of the airframe gives the electrons more space to separate from each other rather than on the inner surface of the metal. I hope this makes sense. But with each lightning strike, you have an entry point and an exit point, similar as if you would pour water over an object. Except there is more damage to the plane with a lightning strike than with water. After getting hit by lightning, the airplane technicians have to perform a thorough search for the entry and exit point of the strike, as the extreme heat of the strike creates nasty burn marks or even holes on the airplane's skin. So for future flights near active thunderstorms, you don't have to worry too much about system losses or engine failures, etc. The airplane is safe from lightning strikes due to the physics law of the Faraday cage, discovered by English physicist Michael Faraday in 1835.
Told you, I trust English physicists. So ever heard of the saying, inside a car is the safest place to hide from a thunderstorm? Because your car acts as a Faraday cage, and so does the airplane. Regardless of that, pilots will always try to circumnavigate thunderstorms by the use of the weather radar and ATC communication.
I'm at 412 requesting heading 070 to avoid weather for the next about 15 miles.
Because airplanes can get damaged in severe thunderstorms, but more likely to turbulence than to lightning strikes. That's it for today. If you ever come to Munich, this museum is worth a visit. Trust me, especially their aviation gallery is outstanding. Make sure to follow me touch and go at my Instagram account, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button plus the notification bell so you won't miss out any upcoming videos. All the best. See you next week. Your Captain Joe.
Please click onto the Away Travel link in the video description below so you don't miss out on this great opportunity on getting $20 discount on your purchase by using the promo code Joe during checkout. I'm very happy with my Away suitcase purchase. Just recently, my phone was about to die after a long day of traveling and started searching for the nearest socket to charge it up again. Admit it, we've all been there. Luckily, having my Away suitcase, I just plugged in the cable into the charger and let the suitcase do the work. Away uses high quality materials while offering a much lower price compared to other brands, as they are selling directly to you. Now, all their suitcases are made with premium German polycarbonate, therefore they are unrivaled in strength and impact resistance, but at the same time are very lightweight. Other than that, if anything breaks, they will fix it or replace it for you, and here comes the best part, for the rest of your life. Have fun shopping and traveling with your Away suitcase, and maybe I'll be your pilot on your next journey traveling far, far away.